Good morning. Alan and I have been asked to award a special award to an alumnus. I'm sorry. I didn't expect it to be this emotional for me. We had hoped that Mrs. Nash would be here to accept this in honor of her husband. I have many great memories of Dean Nash during my years at WA. He was a kind and caring dean. He took a personal interest in the students' lives. I worked for the dean for 2 years. Dean Nash was able to be a friend and still have the respect of the students. He was always calm and composed, even when the guys would try to get a rise out of him, which was often. His effect on my life is only second to my father. I am sure he had that same effect on many students. I cannot think of anyone more deserving of this award than Dean Nash.
So I wanted to, sorry about my voice. I picked a bad time to catch a cold here, but I wanted to add some of my thoughts about Dean Nash. I came to school here at Wisconsin Academy after 12 weeks of my freshman year, and I was here for the rest of my 4 years. I was really lucky because Dean Nash was my dean all 4 years, and then he left after our senior year, so I was always happy that he waited until after I graduated to move on. Dean Nash was always very patient. He was not a flamboyant person. You always knew who was in control of the dorm. I remember we had our assistant dean was John Gatchett, and I'm sure that I've heard that that Mr. Gatchett or Dean Gatchett became a great dean, but he didn't have it figured out yet when we were there. And so on the nights when he was acting dean, it was like a firefight. I mean, everything was just out of control. We'd be down in worship and everybody was cutting up. And sometimes, I don't know if it was because he heard all the noise or he just stepped in, but Dean Nash would step into the back of the room and somebody would notice him back there, and pretty soon the whole room was just quiet. He didn't have to say a word. You just knew, okay, the guy that's in charge is in the room. He had a tradition of, if he heard somebody swear, he would invite them to his office and he would hand them an onion to eat. One time, Jeffrey Vanderventer was heard saying something that he shouldn't have said. And so he went into the office and Dean Nash gave him an onion and he ate the onion. When he got through, he said, "That was damn good." Dean Nash didn't say anything. He just handed him another onion. After he finished the second onion, he was ready to admit that the dean was in charge and he didn't have anything else to say. Also, behind every great man, yeah, as I'm sure you've all heard, is a great woman. And Rosie Nash I had the privilege of spending some time with her because I used to cut hair when I was in the academy, and I cut Stevie's hair. Well, I'm sure he's Steve now, but he was Stevie then. So I would get to spend time with the Nashes a little bit. And Rosie was a sweet, loving, strong woman that I always admired. Unfortunately, she wasn't able to be here today, but Rosie, if you're listening, we really loved having you behind our dean. I'm going to read the plaque. Because they're not here, we're going to be sending this plaque to the family. I'm just going to read real quickly what it says. In honor of James R. Nash, boys dean and teacher at Wisconsin Academy from 1962 to 1970. I think that might be a misprint. I think he was here from 61 to 70. For his superior leadership at Wisconsin Academy, his genuine love for students, and an unfailing concern for their spiritual well-being, exemplifying why this school exists. He will always be a defining part of Wisconsin Academy. His example of Christ-like character to all the young men he saved will live on throughout eternity. In the path of righteousness is life, and in his pathway there is no death. Proverbs 12:28. Because they weren't able to be here, they sent a response to the presentation today, and I want to read that to you. Thank you for honoring Jim, a dean and leader to many of you, and a husband and dad to us. Our hearts are full and we are grateful. It is especially meaningful to know that he is still remembered even after all these years. Dean of Boys at Wisconsin Academy was his first job out of college. One of the boys was only a year younger than the dean. After his 9 years, 1961 to 1970 at WA, Jim continued his career in Adventist education, serving as principal and vice principal for 32 more years in three additional schools. Over these 41 years, he was always patient, faithful, willing to roll up his sleeves to take on practical jobs too, and especially driven by a deep desire to be relevant to young people of the day. We lost him to cancer in 2002 at the age of 64. We will miss him every day and are so grateful for the great hope we have for the future. Thank you, Wisconsin friends. May God continue to bless Wisconsin Academy. Thank you.
Dreamed I went to heaven. You were there with me. We walked upon the streets of gold beside the crystal sea. We heard these angels singing. Someone called your name. You turned and saw this young man, and he was smiling as you came. And he said, "Friend, you may not know me now." Then he said, "Boy, you used to teach my Sunday school, and I was only eight. Every week you would say a prayer before the class would start. One day when you said that prayer, I asked Jesus in my heart. So thank you for giving to the Lord, 'cause I am a life that was changed. So glad you came. Then another man stood before said, remember the time a missionary came to your church and his pictures made you cry, and you didn't have much money, but you gave it anyway. Well, Jesus took the gift you gave, and that's why I'm in heaven today. So thank you for giving to the Lord. I am the life that was changed. Oh, thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you came. One by one they came, far as your eyes could see. Each life somehow touched by your generosity. And it was the little things you done, sacrifices you made, while they were unnoticed on this earth, in heaven now proclaim. You're not supposed to cry, but friend, I'm almost sure there were tears in your eyes as Jesus took your hand and you stood before the Lord. He said, my child, look around you, for great is your reward. Forgiving to the Lord, 'cause I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so so glad.